Hello and welcome to another, yeah, commentary. Not so much. It's more about, as you have seen in the screenshots, thumbnail, that yeah, I try to help you out when playing Cruiser. So basic Cruiser gameplay, yeah, tips I would say. And this one is treating the kiting part. So what does mean kiting, or in terms of World of Warships? Kiting means that you are playing somewhat semi-passive. if you are outnumbered on a flank, for example, or in a certain part of the map, and yeah, you have to still try to delay the enemy as much as you can, or even kill them or sink them, then you need to kite. And the best ship for doing that, in my opinion, is a cruiser. While you can still kite also in a battleship or in a destroyer, kiting is basically, as I said, a delaying action. And for that, you need to know how to do it. It's not about only the angling or and so on. First of all, you need to get into a situation where you can actually kite. And maybe I should pause this, because this is really important. First of all, you need to know, you need to have the information. What are you facing, right? So usually you have destroyers, which have a really slow, low detection range, which means that they are perfectly suited for scouting operations and screening, as it is called, and can show you what is going on the enemy side of the map, basically. Usually, if your destroyer is bad, then you have a big problem, because then he will die quickly. Yeah, if you're yeah, then the problem is that the enemy has usually a spotting advantage. So I try to simplify this thing a bit by choosing a game where I have only one destroyer. In this case, a Shiratsuyu, who's spawned in the middle of the map, so can't be on this side of the map. And how do you approach a situation that you don't know what will happen? I mean, we have a carrier in the game, as you can clearly see, who is also scouting. Still, we don't know very much. Right now, you only see the Massachusetts. And my intention is, since I'm playing the Oba and have concealment build with 10.5 kilometer concealment, if I look at what I could potentially face as a cruiser, Amalfi, Fidschi, Pensacola, Trento, only the Fidschi can outspot me. So this is very important to know. And yeah, if you want to make it really, really careful, you reverse into the enemy. If you are using a ship like the Aoba, so Japanese cruisers are usually pretty stealthy, then you can do this as well. You see me, I'm always looking out for my detection range, which is like the circle here with the yeah, cut ring, I don't know how it's called, this shape. And this is basically what I work around with. You see my distance to the spotted ships now. I mean, there's already some fire exchanged, and yeah. So also the thing here is I'm low tier, right? And we are facing at least one top tier battleship. That's the Massachusetts, which can rip you apart quite easily. But even same tier battleships are a problem for cruisers. I don't know what you've seen in other videos, but usually you don't want to lose, at least in the start of the game, not too much HP on the on your cruiser, especially if you don't have a heal. And you don't want to tank. That's the job of your battleships, usually. So you need to find a good point of engagement. I mean, okay, it's all a bit more than just kiting, but this is also showing you how to start engaging. So, and this is like the interesting point. Aoba has 14.9 kilometer range, so that's not much. So Massachusetts is open at 12.8, probably because he shot. So that gives me time to turn northwards. And what I'm basically doing is getting into a kiting position. Getting my torpedoes off, this is also very important. Aoba has 10 kilometer torps. You can practically not stealth torp, but you can stealth torp if the enemy is progressing or pushing. So this is also a very interesting thing to know. So I just start to launch some speculative torpedoes. So, and now I'm opening up on the Massachusetts when angled away. That's the first thing. Many people don't have the patience or not the knowledge and so on. You don't want to make a full turn in front of the enemy unless you are concealed, especially not if your enemy consists out of battleships. I mean, cruisers are also very problematic in this case, simply because if you have AP shooting or AP based cruisers, it's gonna be a real problem. So that Massachusetts is also doing a pretty smart job. I mean, we are playing standard battle, so there's no cap to gain right now. He's also turning away. And in a perfect game, these engagements are taking place over and over. Yes, I know that's not so action driven as some of you might love it, but it's the basic behind it, right? But usually people make the mistakes and push into you, which is obviously very favorable, no matter which ship you are, usually. And unless they have like really superior numbers, like a lemming train, for example, and you have three ships, well, then you better don't shoot and conserve your HP. Just run and give the rest of your team time to push somewhere else, right? To get a good map positioning or lure them into a crossfire. So basically, this kiting is engage, disengage. If the enemy is not pushing anymore, well, then you can start turning around and move towards the enemy again. Always, in this case, I'm more like a destroyer slash cruiser, because I'm also increasing our spotting range, so my battleships have targets to shoot at. And I'm always choosing wisely my engagement. It's just like, I'm not shooting all the time. I mean, yeah, cruisers have a lot of DPM, but I mean, as I said, if I would be maybe top tier or so, that's a different story, but as low tier in such a game, problematic, right? So that Fuso is also turning away after not seeing probably so much. The problem for them is basically they don't see much, and I show them I provide my team a lot of vision. Fuso is kiting away, so shooting him is not necessarily a good idea. You expose yourself, and even if you set a fire, he can easily damage con it and then just run further away, and the damage won't stick. But you risk your ship, because if I try to chase him, well, the Massachusetts decided already it's time to push again. So I would end up in a crossfire, and that's everything you want to avoid usually. So I'm turning around in stealth, turn my guns, and try to take some pot shots on the Massachusetts again. I mean, this is a very, very boring example of how to kite, but this is basically how it's going on. After this part where I show how to kite, I definitely have also an interesting game in an Otago for you, which I will show you later, where there's a lot of stuff, or a lot of more stuff in there, but it's also more exciting, right? Because it shows you like a full game of cruiser gameplay, or kiting cruiser gameplay, let's say. So, Massachusetts is occupied with shooting something else, so I'm taking this opportunity as well and deal some damage. The damage count, and I'm taking the shots all the time and annoy him. I mean, every bit of damage is good, especially on a tier 8 battleship. I mean, as I also said, the Massachusetts is playing it quite nicely, even though he's showing full broadside to the Massachusetts, to my Nelson, but I'm not sure. My Nelson is shooting HE, so is trying to set some fires again. So I'm lucky I'm setting a fire that will usually stick, and Massachusetts is smart enough to turn away. So this is basically how this whole thing works here, right? Messer is either very passive player, what I don't think, but he's smart enough to know that he doesn't want to push a Nelson with cruiser support. Yeah, I'm dodging by slowing down. Over these ranges, it's even hard for good battleship players to reliably hit you. I mean, yeah, Auber is a very squishy ship, so usually if the Massachusetts hits me one time really hard, he probably scores the Citadel and I'm down to half HP. So that's how vulnerable these low-tier or mid-tier cruisers are. So you have to be extra patient. If you have the opportunity of using an island, well, that's a different story. Then you can just dish out the damage. But in this situation, that's not the case. But we need to, like, hold this flank, basically, right? Sadly, on the other side, my team is doing whatever, but definitely not holding their ground. Or they are in full retreat, as you can see here already, and don't do too much. And yeah, I'm repeating this over and over. And this is basically, well, this is the base of how to kite. How is this gameplay working and so on and so on. And let me accelerate it a bit, because I'm doing exactly the same. My torps should be reloaded by now. Yeah, Fusa is pushing a bit. And I open fire here on the New Mexico. Because Massachusetts ran a bit, and now I saw that the Fuso is shooting HE, and now New Mexico makes a massive mistake, and this is turning in. Once you've turned in, and you don't have the spotting advantage, there is no way that you can ever disengage without making a full turn. And as a low-tier battleship, yeah, that might be boring, but now he's dead. He's absolutely screwed, and he won't do that much to a Nelson. A Nelson is obviously focus fired, but he has a super heal, so he doesn't bother that much. So I'm turning away again, and this is like the favorable situation that you want to have. Yeah, and also New Mexico damage confirmed fire, so obviously it doesn't help. And yeah, this is the perfect situation for a cruiser. A lonely battleship trying to push into nowhere just because patience. I mean, at that point, okay, the game is won for the enemy, that's for sure. But usually you see that also without us losing the battle so hard, right? So this is the basic principles of kiting. In a situation where you have a destroyer, well, accompany destroyer, so basically know the detection of your destroyer and keep the distance behind that. If you have good guns that can damage enemy destroyers, like the Auber has good HE alpha, and yeah, just keep the distance between you and the destroyer, so that if the enemy, if your friendly destroyer spots an enemy, you will be spotted as well, or even behind a little bit. Yeah, and also be already in a situation where you have turned away, or keep that in mind that you have to turn away. So you don't want to approach like nose in for all the time. You have to turn like this shape, or have maybe like 50 45 degree angle towards the enemy or expected enemy ships, so you don't need too much time to turn away. All right, so and from now on, this is we are in the shit, because now only the Nelson, myself and the Tirpitz is alive, and nothing special is happening except for that we lose this game pretty convincingly. But basic kiting action. So let's go over to the game that I promised you, which is a bit more interesting, which contains a lot more than just kiting. So, see you in a bit. Alright, so, promised you, here is another full replay of a game in my Atago. Japanese premium tier 8 cruiser, in a matchmaking where I'm the mid-tier, which is okay. And the thing with the Atago is it has a heal, right? It is still vulnerable, so you have a very, very extended citadel that goes almost along the whole ship, so you're also almost only tanking HE fire very well. If you show too much broadside, the enemy will just rip you apart and score citadels. Good thing about Atago as well, has pretty strong concealment or good concealment, 9.3 kilometers. 10 kilometer torpedoes, 8 on each side, which are where you can actually or effectively stealth top. Good thing about this particular game is also that there is no carrier. That means you can play around your spotting advantage, and this is really important. So I will do exactly the same as I did in the last game. Also check the lineup. There's only one radar, which is the Atlanta, which also helps. I mean, you end up sometimes in tier 10 games where you have Stalingrads, Nevskys with 12-kilometer radars. You always have to take that in consideration as well. Have to play a bit more careful, or with the carrier, obviously, who can extend the enemy spotting suddenly on your flank, and you have to be ready to turn him. As soon as I see ships approaching, I'm immediately turning away, usually. And this is like very, in a cruiser at least, unless I want to commit myself or so. Just because of that reason. Because if you get focused too hard, so then you just die usually. If you are forced in a position where you only can reverse to get out of the concealment range of the enemy, you did something wrong in the approach to that situation. All right, so Pommern, Jambard are spotted here. I take a pot shot and now I'm not shooting anymore. I'm on the top first. Also, big lesson in Japanese cruisers, yeah. If you have this like the gap between spotting and and torp range, then just use it. I mean, as I said, in the Ober it has 10 kilometer torps, 10.5 kilometer concealment. If the enemy is pushing into you, well, then you can always use it. And now I'm spotted. This is a bit of a strange thing. Didn't expect that, but was just merrily spotted, which is a indicator that the destroyer is coming close. But I wanted to get my torps as well out. And now I have my guns ready and I'm opening up. Opened up a bit earlier, but you see that the Jambard has the before I fully turned away, but the Jambard has the guns on the other side, so no big deal. He also will most likely eat a torpedo. He's doing exactly that. Pommern is good enough to dodge this torps, it looks like, yeah. And I get shot by the Jambard. Launching a plane simply to extend my range, my spotting range. Especially if when ships fire, they have a way larger spotting range. And now I can use this island to my advantage and just dish out damage without getting shot at because the enemy has no spotting range. For example, the enemy Minsk did a massive mistake here, in my opinion, by not keeping me spotted. Would have been an easy time for him to spot me, but he didn't. And I seriously don't know, maybe he saw the Donskoy and was really a bit undecided. But yeah, that's definitely what shouldn't happen, usually. And that gave, look at my damage counter, I have already 40k damage in not even 5 minutes of the game. And my average damage in Atago is, I think, around 70-80k. So that's quite massive, right? And always the combination between fires and floodings and so on. And always take a time out if you want to get rid of torpedoes and so on. I mean, now it doesn't make sense to torpedo them. Torpedoes make mostly sense if they are pushing into you, right? That's not the case here. So, keeping also an eye on the Pommern if he's turning around to shoot me. But he's occupied. I mean, that's why you have priority target, right? So, you see when you are getting targeted. I was able to make the full turn without, or almost full turn, without getting targeted, and I'm safely behind this island. It may come to the situation where you underestimate whatever the enemy's ability to switch targets, and you are maybe focused in a full turn and getting shot at, well, then go full speed, maybe reduce half speed and go full rudder to that side where you were intending to put turn in, and hope and pray that you don't get completely punished. I mean, it can happen, especially for inexperienced players or newer players who are not so familiar with all the situations, or where the whole input of the game is still too overwhelming to select or focus on the important parts. But yeah, never stop. I mean, it might work over longer distances, but on shorter distances, never stop. Try it. But if the enemy has a good aim, usually, and good dispersion, you are dead. Unless you have a turtle back or something like that. All right, so next step, after they left the flank and we won the flank, I'm a bit more central. I use my concealment to approach all the time. As I said, I don't need to shoot all the time. This is not necessarily better. Some well-timed HE volleys than just like constant spam. Atago is anyways not designed for it. It has 15 second reload on the 10 guns, but they hit like a truck. So if you hit, you're doing massive damage because of the good HE alpha of the Japanese cruisers. So we want to gain this cap, because on the other side it looked pretty rough for our team. They completely lost it, so we have to win this side if we want to win the game. And I mean, we dropped the enemy ships quite low, yeah, and that's a dead Atlanta. As I said, 3k HE alpha, that's no joke. 5 of 10 shells, so a full volley of 10 is probably hitting for, yeah, 6-7k if unsaturated. And here I'm dishing out damage on the Jambard. I'm trying to use the island as cover to just farm without being in any danger, while it is looking very dire on the other side. You see 5k salvos, so this HE is very, very potent. I have to reverse because the ship didn't stop in time. But, and you see here a lot of tools how to play cruiser, right? Right now I use the terrain to not get farmed. Sometimes you don't have these options and you are forced to like kite like a in I mean, if you have a high DPM cruiser that is basically having a lot of damage output and is somewhat tanky maybe or agile, you can obviously also shoot the whole way while you kite away from the enemy, right? For example, a Wooster or so. You just stop if you drop too low in the in terms of your HP. That's all. So here I'm pushing in, trying to get the cap, but the Sovetsky Soyuz and the Colorado got it already. Loaded preemptively AP because there is a target in that where my RPF is headed, and I'm torping there. Have AP loaded. And maybe the tipper comes out and gets completely wrecked by my torpedoes or by my AP. It's not the case, but I'm making a full turn because I want to create some more map presence. As we've seen, the enemy. Right now, we are still okay-ish in terms of map presence. Now we have this map presence, basically. Shocking moment. The York released the 6 km torpedoes to whatever. The problem is, okay, our battleships are here in the middle and can tank. That's okay. Our Flint misses spotting, so I move down here to provide spotting so he can dish out damage, because this is important. Flint is basically an Atlanta with smoke, but without somebody spotting something for you, it's pretty helpless. So, and we are doing exactly the same again. We approach as close as we can and then get the torpedoes off. In this case, on the Soyuz. I hope he will approach. Choose a different target so he doesn't immediately realize that I'm here, and hope that the torpedoes will hit. This is basically how it works. Minnesota goes down. Scores is turning away. And I'm staying angled, obviously, to the Soyuz. Seeing, I'm watching. Oh, he just shot. This is perfect. Okay, now I can use my gunstun without being in too much danger. Torpedoes, I think, reloaded on the other side, if I'm not mistaken, so didn't help me too much. Soyuz is ignoring me. This is also a mistake. Why would you shoot the battleships in front who are angled towards you instead of the cruiser that is dishing out the HE damage? That Soyuz should target me immediately, because I'm a very, very dangerous target. Even though he has damage con really quickly available, and since he completely ignores me, I'm playing also a bit more cocky. I mean, Atago is an agile ship, so, and even if you do a mistake and maybe underestimate the enemy's capabilities of targeting you, well, then you can still turn away, and usually if you're angled, you don't get deathstruck. That's really, really rarely the case. And you have still a heal. So here I'm playing a bit with fire, but I'm still okay. I wanna get my guns, all of my guns on target. And you see the turrets, I mean, on this distance, it's fine. He's not even caring about me. This is pure, yeah. Inexperience, I don't know, could be. It's also a myth that you have to be as close as possible to be effective. Yes, the Russian battleships are designed to be close, but the problem is, once a low battleship or a battleship is dropping low, it feels the urge to ram then, to trade as good as he can. And yeah, it's often a case where someone doesn't expect that. So here on this side, there's something else going on. I mean, I can ignore the scores. This is HE fire, not over long distances, but I can't ignore the Azuma. He has pretty powerful 3 or 5 millimeter guns, so I'm angling towards him. Yeah, and you see what happens to the Soyuz. You see our Musashi, he dropped really low, and he rams the half HP. Yeah, Sovietsky Soyuz, and takes him out. So, very well played, because that's like the maximum use of your HP. And basically that opened all room in the north, just because the enemy wanted to win harder, didn't prioritize targets, and yeah, that's why they lost. And I mean, it didn't demonstrate a bit like pushing, kiting. I mean, in the end it was basically only pushing. So now this Azuma is here, having HE loaded. Okay, that's not such a big deal. I launched my torpedoes preemptively. So he's angling, this is not so bad. I'm also running last stand on my Atago, there's a reason for that. Simply because I know how quickly the rudder gets knocked out by higher caliber HE fire, or fire with higher HE shells with higher penetration. And this is, I mean, the Azuma doesn't have torps. Right, so I'm angling in because I expect him to shoot AP at some point if he's not completely unexperienced, and he's doing that, but he hits my belt armor at a really bad angle, and now I have to try to torp him and not get ram. Hit only one torp. This was not the best torp run I had so far, but I had to do what is possible, but the flint set a fire on him, and that eventually killed him. And I crown myself not to get rammed, right? I don't want to make him the favor of killing me that easily. And yeah, this is basically game. Not sure if he can get a shot out on the scores. No, nothing is happening. I think the scores was kiting away until oblivion. And that's it, basically. So this was a video where you have everything combined, like kiting, pushing, capitalizing that enemy battleships are ignoring you, These are like the small things, or what? Nah, not so the small things, but even more advanced in the whole package. But yeah, the basics, you know, from the first part of this video. I think it was hopefully helpful. Give me some feedback if that was the case. Apart from that, we are just going here and check the results screen of this game. So 173,000 damage. That's quite impressive in an Atago. 3 Torpils, 13 fire set, 2 kills, Witherer achievement resulted in a 2.2k base XP, and yeah, 60k fires and floodings combined is always a Witherer. You mostly shot, I mostly shot HE for given reasons. Torpedoes, this is your bread and butter, torpedoes and HE, the AP of the Atago isn't that great, so yeah, don't rely too much on it. All right, yeah, that's basically cruiser gameplay basics and then kiting. All right, hope it was helpful. Please give me some feedback, and yeah, see you next time. Bye bye.